watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Hola, habla Cindy. Está viendo Deportes TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So we got some huge news, some huge breaking news, man. Swift Jarrett Hurd has pulled out his December 14th rematch with Julian J-Rock Williams, unified 154 super welterweight junior middleweight champion. As they were scheduled to face off December 14th, Barclays Center, Brooklyn, New York, to stage a highly anticipated rematch, as Julian J-Rock Williams dominated the first fight, dropping Jarrett Hurd in his hometown in D.C., you know, to become unified super welterweight junior middleweight world champion, 154-pound world champion. It's being reported that Swift Jarrett Hurd is looking to have an interim fight before going back into the rematch with Julian J-Rock Williams. But he's also questioning if he is going to stick around the 154-pound division or if he's going to elevate and go up to 160 pounds. He's a very, very big 154-pounder. You know, most people was wondering how he even made the 154-pound weight limit. Now it's being reported that, you know, he is indeed made thinking about moving up to 160. And if that's the case, a fight between himself and Julian J-Rock Williams, the rematch, may never take place because Julian Williams is going to look to become undisputed at 154 pounds. He's looking to gain and fight the winner of Tony Harrison versus Jermell Charlo. It was thought that the winner of Hurd Williams would face the winner of Charlo and Harrison. But now Hurd has pulled out. Reports are that Julian J-Rock Williams could still possibly fight on December 14th date with opponent yet to be named. I would love to see Erickson Lubin step in and replace Swift Jarrett Hurd. Why not? Why not? He had one step-up fight, you know, in the spotlight, should I say, and that was against Jermell Charlo, which he got clipped in the first round and knocked out. You know, he's been looking and you know, paving the way back to the top. You know, that dude has a lot of skills, a lot of talent. You know, he's a southpaw, a lot of power. You know, he got clipped with a shot he didn't see. He bent into it. Jermell Charlo caught him with a nice inside hook, uppercut, and that was all she wrote. You know, Erickson Lubin as a replacement. I know he has a fight coming up, you know, with Gashaw. Listen, why not? Why not? You know, I'm sure Julian Williams is looking to face the best at this point in time. You know, it's not short notice because this is only September. So he has all of October, all of November, and 2 weeks into December. This is the first week of September, so it's plenty of time to get a proper replacement for Swift Jarrett Hurd, you know, to still make that night a huge night, especially if Tony Harrison and Jermell Charlo are still on that card. That would make it, you know, that much bigger. So, you know, it's interesting to see. Let's see how this all plays out. But Swift Jarrett Hurd has pulled out his December 14th rematch showdown with Julian J-Rock Williams and is got his sights, could possibly have his sights set on moving up to 160, which that Julian Williams rematch could possibly be in danger of never happening. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shouts out to the entire LDBC. Shouts out to New Media. Shouts out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.